Hello friends, welcome to our channel. In previous video, we discussed about equivalence relations and some examples of equivalence relation. In today's video, we will discuss the inverse of equivalence relation and functions with their examples. Question: if R is an equivalence relation on the set A, then R inverse is also an equivalence relation on the same set A. Solution: let A be any set and R be the relation on A and it is equivalence relation. We have to prove that R inverse is also equivalence on A. To prove equivalence relation, first we prove that R inverse is reflexive relation. Second, we prove R inverse is symmetric relation. And third, we will prove R is a transitive relation. So we will prove one by one. The first, let A belongs to capital A, B arbitrary. As R is equivalence relation on A, this implies A is related to A, that is AA belongs to R. This implies AA belongs to R inverse. This implies AR inverse A. So R inverse is a reflexive relation. Second, let AB belongs to R inverse. This implies BA belongs to R, but R is symmetric relation. This implies AB is belongs to R because BA belongs to R, then AB is also belongs to R. This implies B A is belongs to R inverse. So if AB belongs to R inverse, then BA is also belongs to R inverse. This implies R inverse is symmetric relation on A. Third, let AB belongs to R inverse and BC belongs to R inverse. This implies BA belongs to R and CB belongs to R. But R is transitive, therefore if CB belongs to R and BA belongs to R, then CA belongs to R. This implies AC belongs to R inverse. Hence, if AB belongs to R inverse and BC belongs to R inverse, BC belongs to R inverse, then AC belongs to R inverse. This implies R inverse is transitive. Therefore, R inverse is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. This implies R inverse is an equivalence relation on A. If a relation is an equivalence relation, then its inverse is also an equivalence relation. Next question. For any relation R, in a set A, we can define the inverse relation R inverse by A R inverse B if and only if B R A, then prove that R is symmetric if and only if R is equal to R inverse. In this question, it is given that R is any relation on the set A. If BA belongs to R, then AB belongs to R inverse. So R inverse is the inverse of the relation R. We have to prove that if R is symmetric, then R must be equal to R inverse. If the relation is equal to inverse to itself, then the relation must be a symmetric relation. Solution. Let R be any relation on the set A. Suppose R is symmetric. We have to prove that R is equal to R inverse. Let AB belongs to R, then BA belongs to R because R is symmetric. This implies AB belongs to R inverse, but AB belongs to R is arbitrary. This implies R is contained in R inverse. Put it equation number 1. Next, let X, Y belongs to R inverse, then Y, X belongs to R. This implies X, Y belongs to R because R is symmetric. But X, Y belongs to R inverse is arbitrary. This implies R inverse is contained in R. Put it equation number 2. From equation 1 and 2, we have R is equal to R inverse. So, if R is symmetric, then R is equal to R inverse. Conversely, suppose that R is equal to R inverse, we have to prove that R is symmetric. Let AB belongs to R. This implies AB belongs to R inverse because R is equal to R inverse. This implies BA belongs to R So if AB belongs to R, then BA belongs to R. This implies R is symmetric. So if R is equal to R inverse, then R is symmetric. Hence, R be any relation on the set then R is symmetric even only if R is equal to R inverse. A relation is a symmetric if and only if its inverse is equal to itself. Next question. How many relations are possible from a set A of M elements to the another set B of N elements. In this question, it is given that A and B are any two sets. A have M elements and B have N elements. We have to find how many possible relation may be there from the set A to the set B. Solution. Number of elements in the set A is equal to M and number of elements in the set B is equal to N. So number of elements in the set A cross B is equal to M into N. We know that a set have N elements, then the number of subsets are 2 raised to power n. All the relations from the set A to B are the subsets of A cross B. So number of possible relations is equal to number of subsets of A cross B, which is equal to 2 raised to power m into n, because A cross B have m into n elements. So how many subsets are possible? 2 raised to power m into n subsets are possible. And the number of subsets of A cross B is equal to number of possible relations. Therefore, if a set have m elements and the set B have n elements, then the number of possible relations from A to B is equal to 2 raised to power m into n. Next function. What do you mean by function? Function is a special type of relation. Suppose capital X and capital Y are any two non-empty sets, then a rule F by which every element of capital X is associated with elements of Y uniquely, then this rule is called a function from the set X to the set Y. We can write it as F is a function from X to Y. The set X is called domain of the function, and the set Y is called codomain of the function. Graphically, capital X and capital Y are any two non-empty set. Let small x is belongs to capital X, small y is belongs to capital Y. Then F is a function, F is a rule by which element of capital X, that is small x, is associated with element of capital Y, that is Y. Small y belongs to capital Y is called image of X under F, that is Fx is equal to Y. and small x belongs to capital X is called pre-image of y under function f. Range: the set of all f images of the elements of set capital X is called range of the function f. The range of function is always a subset of codomain. For example, let capital X is equal to 1, 2, 3 and capital Y is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and f is a function defined as f of 1 is equal to 2, f of 2 is equal to 4 and f of 3 is equal to 6. That is, fx is equal to 2x. Then x 1, 2, 3, y 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 is related with 2, 2 is related with 4, 3 is related with 6. From figure we see that every element of capital X is associated with elements of capital Y uniquely. Therefore, f is a function from x to y. Domain of the function is equal to x is equal to 1, 2, 3. Codomain of the function is equal to y is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Range of the function is equal to set of all f images of the elements of x, that is f of 1, f of 2, f of 3 which is equal to 2, 4, 6. So range of the function is a subset of codomain. So we conclude that if f is a function from x to y, then first point, each element of capital X must be associated with elements of capital Y. Second point, two or more elements of capital X may be associated with same element of capital Y, but an element of capital X cannot be associated with more than one element of Y. Third point, there may be some elements in Y which has no pre-image in capital X. We can write the function f x to y as f x is equal to y, where small x is independent variable and small y is dependent variable. It is sufficient for today. In the next video, we will discuss the classification of the functions and their examples. So keep in touch and watch our videos. Subscribe our channel for more and more videos. Thanks to all. Have a nice day. Bye bye.